I want to show you in this short video how to apply for jobs using a personalized cover letter and then how to organize your job search. So let's go to Indeed website and you search for SEO in London. And you find, let's open three jobs. And then you go to read and you go to SEO in London. And again, you open three jobs. If you will apply, you will see that some of them require you to add a cover letter. It's not mandatory, but you should do it nevertheless. This one is also optional and so on. Okay. So, my suggestion is the following. You will find in the description of the video I have posted on YouTube, you will find a link to my personal blog where you will find a document. And I will serve it as macro enabled. And you will find the document like this. So I suggest you go to View, then to Macros, to View Macros Organizer. So what you will be able, you should do, you should go here, and then you should copy from left to right, and then close and save. So what I have done is I have created this file, and this file you need to open the macros in here. Perhaps it will trigger a security setting. Okay, let's say you have managed to do so. Macros, View Macros, and you will find the macros in here. It shouldn't be like this, Macros for Jobs cover letter. It should be like... Where is it? Like this. It's the same file, but it's in new macros. Okay. So... Once you have copied it, you should close this file because you don't need this anymore and open a new file. I'll close it. But macros view macros, like this. And in this file, you should edit the text you will find in here. These are the text for the first sentence in the cover letter. These are some other text. Whatever you find in quotes, you should edit. It's not very complicated. It's quite straightforward. This is a text at the end of the macro and so on. If you Google it, you should be able to edit the files. And so on. You should read what this thing does. Finally, PS, signature plus date. All sorts of things like that. You can also have the option to use to and so on. So I want to show you what this macro does. Let's open a new document. And in this document, to put on the first line, Control Alt V for not formatting. If you just press Control V, it will be formatted. If you press Control Alt V, it will be unformatted text. So I'll copy the title. And I will copy a few of the descriptions. You could go more. And now I go to View Macros, and I will run the macro. and it has created a cover letter, and with the current date, my phone, you can edit that in the macro, the phone, my Skype ID, and so on. And this is a, if you look carefully at this text, let's run it again. Let's try it with another job. Let's copy this because now it's easier. And just run it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's perfect. You should delete the spaces at the beginning. And to do this easily, you can replace like this. Okay. And now it has created me another cover letter, which is different than the one. If you look very carefully, it's different. And for each of these aspects, you should give a reply. You reply like this. I follow this requirement in the following way. And you reply. And the text is different. My cover letter tool, allows you to set different things like this. So if you send 5 cover letters, some of them perhaps will get to the same employer. Not 5, but 50. You get 2 letters to the same employer. And they will see you have written in the same way these texts. If you, in order to avoid so, I have made a cover letter tool, which allows you to have various texts. So various introduction forum, my intro is different. This is different from one to another, and so on. If you want to run this more quickly, you can go here, more comments, macros. You should look for new macro, okay, and this one, let's have an icon for it. Let's have another job. Let's go to read now. Ctrl-Alt-V. Let's take these settings, for example. Let's say they are requirements. I just click on this thing and it will put this is the title of the job. It didn't like what I'd done, so I just undo a lot of things. It's not enter at the end of this thing, that was the problem. There was no enter. Now there is an enter. So now it worked fine. This is another cover letter, different from the previous ones. And I just need to fill in this information, and it's a good cover letter to work on. Okay, you've done your cover letter. What's the next step? What I suggest you to do is create an Excel file. You will also find it on my website, in which you put the date applied. Let's say 24th March. Job title, you copy paste it. Company, copy paste it. Location, London. Cover letter, copy, F2, paste. Link of the job. You should also file save page and save this on your computer. Let's name it 01 because it's the first job we apply. Okay, another one. SEO manager. After they reply, you post the reply. London. Let's say it's the same cover letter. Another URL. And we save the page. Then when someone contacts you, all you have to do, okay, I applied this, I wrote them this, so I should be able to, when they call me for interview, I should know what I've written to them. And if they reply, I will be able to track my success. That's how I suggest you to apply to jobs. Cheers. Good luck.